Hey guys, Dr. Berg here. In this video, we're going to talk about diagnosing your stool, all right? Number one, if the stool is hard little round chunks, like little balls that are dry, that means you're doing too much protein. I've had people do like protein shakes and that's all they're consuming, no vegetables, and that's what they get, okay? Because protein absorbs a lot of the water in the fluid from your intestinal tract. Number two, unformed flakes. It's almost like a borderline diarrhea, and that usually comes from eating, certain people eat salads or even the kale shake or some leafy greens. They haven't developed the enzymes to actually digest that material. Or maybe they ate too much, and the microbes that live off the fiber are overwhelmed, and so they just cause you to dump it, okay? So that means you're doing a little too much of the wrong type of salad or green, okay? You have to mix it up, change the vegetable to something else, okay? And the enzymes that are supposed to digest that come from microbes, because microbes make enzymes, so it's really a lack of a certain microbe. Number three, floating stool. That means that you have too much fat in your stool because you don't have enough bile, B-I-L-E, from the gallbladder, in which case you need some gallbladder formula to help give you some bile to help to break down that fat. Okay, next one, skid marks on the toilet, in the inside of the toilet. That's a pancreas problem because you don't have the enzyme called lipase in the pancreas, so the pancreas is not releasing the enzyme to digest that, and you get this like black tarry stool type thing, okay? So you need more pancreatic enzymes, all right? And by the way, pancreatic enzymes are in the gallbladder formula, so I put that in there called pancreatin, which actually helps the digestive part of the pancreas, okay? Lastly, dry stool. That happens to be a lack of just friendly flora, a friendly bacteria. It means you need more probiotic that helps you lubricate that and helps you digest and creates kind of a lubrication effect, okay? Now, one last thing is if you have blood in the stool or it's red, you know, rule out if it's a beet situation, if you just ate beets, because that could cause it, or it could be a hemorrhoid, okay? That's the usual common cause. Okay, and lastly, I don't know if you've ever saw a stool sample. I'm not sure if you have, so I actually brought one to show you what a stool sample looks like. Okay, so this is what it looks like. It's brown, and it looks like this. Okay, so that's, if you're curious about what it looks like, that's what it looks like. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Have a good one. Let's go show this to the patients. Come on. Hey, Joanne. Hey, good to see you again. So the stool sample came through. So I just want to know we have the stool sample that we tested. Okay. So I just wanted to make sure that you had that, the results of that.
Okay. Where are the results?
Oh, that's inside.
Oh, okay.
You want to see it? You want to
No, not particularly.
But you see it's the stool sample came out. So I have your stool sample all set that we had it tested.
Oh my God.
And yeah. The results are inside.
Okay. Do you want to open it?
You didn't want to open
no.
it?
No, I don't.
Oh my gosh. It's just, it's the stool sample.
Oh my God.
You thought I meant the actual stool sample?
No. I did.
Yeah. Okay, good. So this wasn't yours then?
No.
So Roxanne, we have the results of the stool sample, and I just wanted to give those to you.
Okay.
They're inside that you wanted to have done, that run, you know, had the lab do it, so we have the results. What?
Hey guys, thank you so much for watching. Your next step is to click the share button below and let's spread the word.